president of Coda. We would like to begin by thanking the University of Oklahoma for their donation of this lovely space and their help running the clinic this weekend. We all over the building, and they were very gracious in allowing us to utilize it. It's a great opportunity for our students. This time I'd like to remind you to please turn off your cell phones and make sure all alarms are off, sound is off, all of those sorts of things, so that we don't interrupt this wonderful performance you're about to hear. If you are interested in purchasing a professional recording, DVD, or CD of this performance, the order forms are available in the lobby after the performance. Additionally, at that space where we're selling the DVDs and CDs, we have some lost items. There was a pair of prescription glasses found backstage, as well as a set of keys found in the lobby. It has a Pioneer County Library card on it. So those are yours. They're at the front of the lobby. We will also be taking a photo at the end of the performance, so those are available for purchase as well. At this time, I'd like to introduce the chairperson for the Wind Ensemble, director of bands at Norman High, Mr. Stephen Myler.
My name is Stephen Myler. I'm the assistant band director over at Norman High School. I've had the opportunity to hang out with these wonderful kids on stage for the last about 36 hours. I think you're in for a real treat with their portion of the concert. I've got to give some awards before we get started. These are the six-year Coda award winners. So these students have made one of the Coda honor bands all 6 years that they have been able to since seventh grade all the way up through their senior year. So in this group, we have 10 students who have earned that award. It's a pretty incredible feat for our students to be able to. So I'm going to call their names, if they'll come up and receive their plaque, and if you'll hold your applause until the end. First one is Tori Vensky from UConn. Gabby Merchant, also from UConn. Bethany Paris, Edmund North. Andy Murray, UConn. Alicia Dick, UConn. Braden Moore, Deer Creek. Rachel Diaz, UConn. Jordan Friedman, Norman High. Jordan Minty, Norman North. And Christian Caputo, Edmund Santa Fe. Let's give all these students a round of applause. Have had the opportunity to work with a truly international conductor. Anthony Maiello is professor of music at George Mason University in Washington, D.C. Teaches applied lessons in conducting, oral skills, and classes in instrumental conducting. He's conducted the Symphony Orchestra and Chamber Orchestra at GMU and has performed at national and international festivals for collegiate bands. He's also a regular guest conductor with the Navy Band, Washington, D.C., and holds degrees from Ithaca College, New York. There's more about him in your program, and you'll hear a little more from him. So here is the Coda Wind Ensemble and their conductor, Anthony Maiello.
Thank you. Forgive me with the microphone, it's always a challenge. Thank you so much for that wonderful applause. We really appreciate you being here. Hope that you enjoy our program. The next piece needs just a bit of explanation and a chance for you to listen for some things. Anytime I go to a concert, I always like to try to inform the audience as to what's going on. Unlike choirs who have words and who can tell the story, bands and orchestras don't and can't move and can't express in terms of words. So this next piece, Turning Point, just a little bit of background. Commissioned by the United States Navy Band in Washington, D.C. for the 60th anniversary of the Battle of Midway. On December 7th, 1941, the Japanese bombed Pearl Harbor, thinking that they destroyed the American fleet there. The Japanese made three big mistakes. Number one, they attacked on a Sunday, and the 38,000 troops there, or military personnel that we had, most of them were on shore, on shore leave. And so when they bombed Pearl Harbor, there were only about 3,800 people that were really lost. Still, devastation. That was the first big mistake they made. The second big mistake they made is that they saw all of those ships lined up in a row and they bombed the ships. What they didn't do was bomb the dry docks. Had they bombed the dry docks, the ships, we would have had to tow every one of those ships back to the mainland for repair. That was the second biggest mistake. The third biggest mistake that they made was that they didn't bomb the fuel tanks just over the hillside. Had they done that, we would have gone totally out of commission. That being the case, Admiral Nimitz, Charles Nimitz, already said, we're on our way to fixing everything. 6 months later, the Battle of Midway takes place. And it was a turning point in the war where the United States Navy, Marines, destroyed four Japanese aircraft carriers, four, in one battle. And that was basically the turning point. That's what this piece is about. You're going to hear in the piece four big hits. BM, would you please find 142 fourth beat? This is, you'll hear four of these, and it comes about later on. Composer Brian Kidd was chief arranger for the United States Navy Band for 20 years, wrote the piece, okay? And right after that, right after those four hits, there's silence and it goes down just like anything else when all of the chaos is over. And you'll hear the first four notes of Anchors Away. So we're going to lay it down for you, all right? Starts off thinking about being in Arlington Cemetery. Lonely trumpet, all by itself. Okay. You will hear the ocean. Guys, just start the ocean. Just start it. I know they weren't working. That's okay. Those are ocean drums, in case you want to listen. Isn't that cool? Nice. So that's how it starts off. Ends. That's like that. Turning Point by Brian Kidd.
Thank you. Thank you.